It's not every day that you come across a young lady in the food and beverage space who actually has no background in this area. Tanvi Chowdhury, the founder of Papa Cream, a well-known ice cream brand with 5 outlets to boot. Having studied engineering and then finance, Tanvi always had a soft spot for food and is very passionate about it. How she delved into the realm of desserts, specifically ice cream, and how she's made a success of her brand is something we'll find out from her. With me is Tanvi Chowdhury, who's going to tell us a little more about her success metrics. Hi, Tanvi.
Hi.
So, Tanvi, tell me, I've gathered that you've sort of studied engineering and then finance.
That's right.
And that's nowhere near the area of food and beverage. So, how does foray into food and beverage?
Food was always a passion. You know, when we traveled growing up, food was an agenda. We would want to try the local cuisine.
Of course.
So, I knew I wanted to do something in the food space.
Right.
And while I was doing finance in New York, that's when I really started to experiment with different flavors and ideas and all these things. And at the end of my finance career in New York, I was sure that this is what I wanted to start.
Wow. And how did you really zero down on desserts and specifically ice cream? What made you decide?
I always loved ice cream.
Okay.
And this is an experiment that I've done in my physics lab during my engineering stint.
It's impressive.
And I learned how to make ice cream using liquid nitrogen because that's what you were studying at that point of time.
Okay.
And I thought it was something really interesting and cool. And while I was there, I saw somebody doing something like this, but I wanted to scale it up and actually make it a commercially viable model.
Actually.
And, having that technical background along with the passion for food and, the desire to create something really unique with interesting flavors,
let
me start Papa Cream.
Oh, lovely. Okay. And why the name Papa Cream?
So, this is a question that I always get because people cannot really relate to it. But, we were just sitting and brainstorming different names. And a lot of people suggested different French names, all fancy patisseries and all these things. And I was just like, I want something that every single person
can relate to,
very can true. Pronounce, and it takes you home. So, while this discussion was going on, it was with my family. And my father-in-law was just like, how about making me the brand ambassador and just calling it Papa Cream? And it was just done in jest, but it just clicked. It struck a chord and I was like, it's Papa Cream.
Wow, so Papa Cream it was, okay.
Yes.
Tell me something, Tanvi. Was entrepreneurship something always on your mind, or did you sort of think that after having acquired these degrees and studies that you did, you would, get into a full-time sort of job?
Well, I did experience, working. That's an experience that I did want to have. So I did have a job while I was in finance.
Okay.
But I knew deep down always that I wanted to be an entrepreneur and in the F&B space. So I was very, very sure and clear about that. I just didn't know which division.
Sure.
F&B. But yeah.
So, but what in you do you think, are the skills or the characteristics of an entrepreneur which you possess? In terms of, why did you sort of always know that you were an entrepreneur at
heart? I think, the skills and qualities are very individual to everyone and how they, convert it into something successful. But I think first thing is having confidence. It's the most important thing. You have to believe in your vision to actually make it happen. And I think second thing is to really be passionate about what you're doing. I think anybody who's doing it, of course you have to do it for commercial reasons.
Very true.
But then having the passion for that thing that you're doing really gives you an extra edge.
Without a doubt.
Yes.
Hey, tell me one more thing. If you think that the first year, if you sort of look back at the first year of Papa Cream, 2015, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
So, what were the tough lessons that you learned in the first year?
When we started, we wanted to make it very gourmet and premium, and it still is. But, when you try to create something like that, it's important to understand the mind of the masses, what they really want, your idea of food. You may have a certain exposure to food.
Quite right.
And you vision it a certain way, but maybe others don't. So understanding and connecting what others want versus what satisfies you creatively, creating the right balance there. And, there are a lot of different divisions. An idea always is cool, but the execution is where the challenge comes.
Completely.
So, you just have to hold your head up high and just focus on your goal, and that keeps you going.
So, but what was, any sort of incidents in the first year that you can recollect, or some sort of, obstacles or impediments that you faced?
No, it's never all smooth. Of course, there were a lot of lessons to learn. I think the first is, I don't know if it's really a good or a bad problem, but we had an overwhelming response. You know?
Wow.
Stuff that we hadn't even factored in or accounted for. So there were too many people the first month. Like there was literally three lines of queue outside. Wow. And so, you know, getting everybody up to speed because it's something we were not prepared for.
Sure.
So that was something really to learn, you know, that sometimes a good problem
unexpected
can also be,
that can
be a thing. And the other thing is also like there are a lot of different divisions. So the idea is always sounds cool, but the execution is very different. And, you know, you may think you're getting into food, but I think at least 60 to 70% of your work is actually operations.
Quite right.
So looking into this new operation.
Yes. I think a lot of people today want to jump onto this food and beverage bandwagon, especially young people, like yourself and others.
Yes.
And they sort of tend to think from the outside that it's a very glamorous field, lots of money, lots of glamour, and like fun things happening, leave your job and do this. Yeah. How would you sort of warn them, or what is the tips that you would give?
Yeah, so I do think that it definitely looks glamorous, because what you see is at the forefront when you go into a store, you really look how beautiful it is, you look at the good products. So that is something you get enamored by and you want to get into it. But there's so much more. In fact, 90% of the work is actually in the back end. So do be mindful. It's challenging and everything is. But yes, in terms of just the F&B space, I think it's a great space to be in. It's booming, growing. People are very experimental. You want to try different things.
Sure.
So, you know, if you really love food, then yeah, just go for it. You know?
Wonderful. Wise words. Mm-hmm. Tanveer, tell me one last thing. What do you really think contributes to success? Is it hard work, knowledge, skills, or luck?
I mean, I think it's a combination of, all these things. Hard work, having the right vision, mm-hmm. and, just going towards your goal. And sometimes when you begin, you may not really have the right vision, but to pick yourself up, you know, see through the whole thing and then go again. Just being at it, I think, really gets you there.
How would you define success now? What does success mean to you?
I think success... success, at no point should you feel like, okay, this is it, I'm successful now. Because, as Steve Jobs correctly puts it, stay hungry, stay foolish. But, I think also at some point giving yourself credit that, yeah, I've achieved my goals or something. So having a vision and really seeing people, acknowledge it and feeling that, yeah, I have actually achieved what I'd aimed for is success.
Wow.
Yeah.
That was very succinctly put by Tanvi Chaudhary of Papa Cream. Success obviously means different things to different people. Not one to rest on her laurels. 5 outlets and many more to come. That's Tanvi for you. If you enjoy watching Mini's Food Fundas, do subscribe to my channel.